truth can hurt you, or the truth can change you. What will truth do to you?
I just wanna be happy, but if I keep on doing the things that keep on bringing me pain, there's no one else I can blame.
Hello everybody, Snook here. And today, I want to tell everybody I'm sorry. See, the last time I was on the YouTube airwaves, I offended some people with some things I said. I said something about a fat ass. I know. Pretty disgusting. I just hope that, you know, me identifying as a man, as a heterosexual man, has not been easy. I've struggled with this inner unrest for a lot of years, probably 29 years now. It hasn't been an easy struggle. I've tried to just suppress it and push it down inside me. Few understand truly how tough it is to be a genuine man. So I come to you today in my home, just so you can see into the true Snook and see that I struggle being a genuine man.
And he also just seems so genuine, and I find that genuine men like big butts. And
being a genuine man isn't easy. Few truly understand the dominator lifestyle. Because the fact is,
look, she's just so flat.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny that when a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face, you get sprung. Wanna pull up tough because you notice that butt was stuck. The jeans she's wearing, I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh baby, I wanna get whipped up and take your picture. My homeboy's trying to warn me, but that butt you got makes
me so horny.
Ooh, rump of smooth skin. You say you wanna get in my bins? Well, use me, use me.
What were you thinking? It's just woodworking. So since the last time you saw me, I got this incredible new couch. Check it out. Everybody knows when you get a new couch, you gotta get new end tables, you gotta get a new coffee table, entertainment center, entryway table. I just gotta redo the entire thing. And like I told everybody in the beginning, I'm gonna build everything out of plywood for this one. So let's go downstairs and check out what I've been building. So now, let's go check out the stuff I got made. So I started building my coffee table. I wanted my coffee table to be supported on one end, but dangling on the other side, because I want to be able to put this coffee table underneath the couch to where now I have a tabletop on top of the couch because it's so deep. So I started building this thing, and here's the center pylon for it. There's the centerpiece that's gonna be on one end, and the table's gonna stick out. And as you can see, I got another piece of plywood here, and this is the top. So all I did was glue three pieces of plywood together, made these shapes, glued them all together, and then I got my base. set it up here. And it'll all go together like this. Oh, shit. It'll sit here like that. And then this table will sit here like this. So as you can kind of get an idea, this is what it's gonna look like. I've also been busy building the kiln upstairs. So I took all the walnut that I had downstairs and put it up in the attic, but then I had to wire a fan to go up there. That way it could draw the moisture out of the wood as the attic heats up. So I got in the electrical panel and I got in the attic. Check it out. That's what I was trying to pull off, was getting the wood dried up here in the heat of the day, and then putting the fan there to kind of get rid of the moisture in the wood, so hopefully it'll be ready by spring. So, kiln is done. All right, everybody. Thanks for watching this episode of Snook here, and hopefully you stay tuned because I got a lot of furniture that I gotta start building for this couch. This couch is enormous, and before you say it, yeah, it is pretty nice. So make sure you're watching, and as always, Snook here.